Welcome. Let's talk about deep purpose now. So you're saying, what exactly is deep purpose? Well, we have the man who can answer that question, because he's written a book called Deep Purpose, The Heart and Soul of High Performance Companies. He's also professor of business administration at Harvard, and he is Ranjay Gulati. Thank you for joining us.
My pleasure. Thank you for having me today.
And we also have the pleasure of having Bühler Group's very own CEO, Stefan Scheiber, who has been with Bühler for more than 30 years in different functions and CEO of Bühler for 6 years. And purpose has always been a deep part of Bühler's culture, and Stefan is taking it to greater heights. Thank you so much, Stefan, for being here.
Thank you, Mafina.
So, Ranjay, let's start with deep purpose. Every company has a purpose, even if it's only to make money, right? How does deep purpose differ from just having a purpose?
So I really wanted to call the book Purpose. So, but I couldn't, because I discovered so many companies practice what I learned was superficial or convenient purpose. So purpose was either a mission statement, so you're basically putting something on the wall, or even if it was more than a mission statement, you know, it was very narrowly circumscribed and defined around typically delivering shareholder value. And I came to realize there was only a few companies. So in a strange way, you know, normally you write a book about something that is happening in many companies. I was studying what we call niche companies, exemplary companies. It's not the norm, it's the exception. And these companies were taking purpose deep into the DNA of how things got done in the company, part of the operating rhythm. But then the question was, what was the purpose itself? So there's, how deep do you go with the purpose? Then the question was, is it a good purpose or not a good purpose, right? You can be, a gang can have deep purpose too, right? So you might say mafia, the mafia was deep purpose. They shared a purpose,
yeah,
right? So what does purpose include? Purpose has, first of all, goals, ambition. We're gonna be successful. We're gonna do well. We're gonna perform in the market. But along with that goals came a sense of duties, responsibilities. We have a responsibility to our shareholders, to our employees, to our customers, to our community, and to the planet. Now, how do you get that? It starts by having both a short-term understanding of where our business is going, but also a long horizon into our business. The moment you start thinking long horizon, you naturally think of multiple stakeholders. So you see all these ideas coming together. It was long horizon while keeping short-term goals in mind. It was multiple stakeholders. It was goals with duties, and then taking these ideas deep into the operating rhythm of the company.
But how do you stop a company hijacking that idea and using it as a PR exercise? Because duties are a word you use quite a few times there. If we can give a semblance of duty and we're doing good for the community, that's enough.
You know, I think this is what many companies have done, and they have played into the hands of the cynics, who now say purpose is just a joke. Purpose washing. This is just a smoke and mirrors PR. In fact, one observer has called this virtuous side hustles. Right? Virtue scamming. I mean, they have harsh words for purpose now, and rightfully so. You know, and you see companies that deliberately use purpose as a way to deflect pressure. So when Facebook was in trouble in 2016, Congress had Mark Zuckerberg being asked to testify. What do? They pulled out a purpose. We're going to make the world a better place and have people connecting with each other. And suddenly you're like, oh, no, we're trying to be a good person. Look at our purpose. So I think there's too much of that going on that then makes the whole idea get tainted. Mm. And I think, I feel it's a lost opportunity. Its purpose is about unlocking value, unlocking potential in the employees who work for us, in our business model itself, in our understanding of how we can both be successful in the short and long term. It's missed opportunity. I think purpose, just like any other strategic web tool or implementation tool, brings energy into an organization.
And Stefan, I know that purpose is something that's very near and dear to your heart. What does deep purpose mean to you?
Well, for me, it means that as you rightly said in the introduction, spent about 3 decades of my life in this company, in different countries, different continents, on different continents, and always somehow interacting either with customers or internally with our people. It means to just carry the flag for our company and for our industries as well, like what we do at the Networking Days here, into the future. You know, that notion that this company we are working for, we are privileged to work for, has been around five generations, has been in existence for 162 years, is on the one hand side something which makes you very proud. But on the other side, you also ask yourself, well, how do I make sure that I'm not the guy who actually runs it into ground, right? To use now a little bit of some cynical expression. So really, that was how I always saw it. And I came to terms, and Ranjay and his studies and his lectures at Harvard helped me also to change my own sort of link to it or connection to it, because it can overwhelm you, right? It can overwhelm you. And the risk that you would actually just try to do everything to hang on to what is there and what our predecessors have generated is very high. So that thing which we could call or could summarize like play not to lose. But Ranjay's thoughts and also this idea that we could actually take it to the next level, that we could free up additional energy and performances as well, quite like our predecessors did when they were in charge. That is then the change which was necessary for me, which is sort of my calling, you could actually say, and then the notion changes more towards like a play-to-win approach.
And so you've had three decades of really exploring the purpose of Bühler. What has it meant, or how has it contributed to the success of Bühler? And what will it mean for the long term? How do we drive this in the long term as well?
You know, the problem at Bühler is we always, and also people who were for a long time at Bühler, the problem was that we felt good about it, but we didn't really know why, right? Until couple of years ago, we started to sit down and actually said, what is actually our purpose, right? And we took a couple of people together and then we tried to sort of write it up. And then we talked to international people. We actually interviewed everybody in the company. So everybody could say, you know, contribute to that context and to that concept of who are we, why are we doing it, how are we doing it, etc. And it came all natural. And it was quite interesting. People were engaged because I said, for the first time, somebody's actually asking the question. Up to now, we all just did it somehow, right? Which I think is the nice way to have, right? It's much, much more difficult and perhaps even impossible to just create an artificial purpose and change a 150, 60 years old company with a couple of thousands employees towards that goal. So I think that's a huge privilege. And of course, that has the power to unleash even more energy and performance and passion for what we are doing in the future.
So Stefan mentioned there, Ranjay, about getting buy-in from colleagues, getting them to contribute. Is that the way that you find your deep purpose, by being collaborative? Do you sit down, as Stefan was saying, with people and say, right, where are we headed? What are we doing here? Or is it more organic than that sometimes?
So I think Stefan made two very important points I thought I'd share with you. And to answer your question is, so I looked at a number of companies in my research, 18 companies, small and large, and several of them actually use purpose as part of their turnaround strategy to transform the business. So it was interesting, Microsoft being one of them, Lego being another one. Lego was almost bankrupt. Microsoft was in deep trouble, had been stagnant for 15 years. So as the transformation of the company, they said, how do we bring new, fresh thinking? How do we, to you what he said, Stefan said, play to win. How do we bring that winning mindset into our organization? Both had been very successful before. And then when they started to think about their purpose, they did the following. They said, what Jörn Vignotstrup said to me was, he said, you don't invent a purpose, you detect a purpose. Mm-hmm. You have to detect it because it's already in the organization. Another company in India, Mahindra, they did the same thing. They actually had a marketing consultant come and say, we want a branding strategy. And he said, so he was going around talking to people in the company to get what the essence of the brand was. And he came back and told the chairman that, look, I can give you the essence of brand, but you have something else going on in your company. There's something fundamental that you haven't put your finger on. It's something very profound. And so we got to bubble it up. Now, what is interesting is, not only do you then discover what the DNA of the company is, but then you, as you engage people, they also realize that, oh, there's something, as, again, I want to, there's something special about us. We don't know what it is. And let's try to, now, sometimes that is great. But if a company is trying to move away from the past, sometimes they have to do a refresh on it. Even at Harvard Business School, we had a purpose. So in the beginning, 100 years ago, it was helping people make a decent profit decently. Mm. I love that, okay? Decent profit decently. The problem was that, what is decent? And how do you decent and decently become too ambiguous sometimes, right? And people have exposed justified. So we then did a refresh on it, which is called Educating Leaders Who Make a Difference in the World. We wanted to bring in what we actually do, educate, right? World, global, not just American. So there was, but I agree with your, to your larger point is, I think engaging others in the discovery process makes them feel involved. But in the end, you can't vote people into a sentence. In the end, somebody has to sit down and say, okay, I took the input, we processed the input, and yes, you put a one line out, but then you, what do you do with the line? It's the, we, I think we get focused on the line. Mm. What's our purpose statement? The statement is just one, words. It's empty.
It's not the culture. The culture is within.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, Stefan, what are your views on making a decent profit decently? As Ranjay just said, is there possibly a trade-off between having a deep purpose and having economic benefit? Or how do those two interact in your perspective?
That's a very good point. And my thesis is it's exactly the opposite. I do believe in the longer run, perhaps not in the shorter run, but in the longer run, I do believe that purpose, deep purpose, can actually accelerate performance, also financial performance. When we look at sports, that's what you know, the really good coaches do. They take professional athletes, and all of them are professionals. All of them want to do good to the next level, and over a long time. And when they change the team, they do it yet again. And I think that's the difference. That's what good leadership means. And So I do not believe that this is an opposite. In other words, to the contrary, I do believe this is the back and the front side of the same coin. Particularly now that we see that actually boundaries are changing, systems are changing, the questions of energy, the questions of having enough food for a growing amount of people across the world, the question of disruptions with technologies, etc., etc. Given the overall situation, I do believe that, or of course, mainly sustainability aspects, given the overall situation, I think it is very, very important that you have to have a good purpose such that you can really ensure long-term true north performance and also have a good relation to your stakeholders in and outside the company. I think it's as important for the inside of the company as with the outside of the company. And here perhaps we can refer to a nice little test which Professor Gulati made with our customers yesterday. Perhaps we can actually talk about that really, because the clue is it's all nice and dandy to see a purpose from within and believe that's it. The proof of the pudding is how do your customers or your partners and stakeholders do it. And that takes a lot of effort.
And actually on that, so I actually, what we did was, I did a word cloud exercise where they put in one word and the words populate into the screen. And if the same word is typed twice or three times, that word gets bigger and bigger, right? So I asked these 300 or so people who are customers, ecosystem partners, non-Bühler people mostly, I would say. And I said, can you describe Bühler's, none of them I don't think knows Bühler's purpose, really. I don't think so. No one, maybe they remember it or not. I said, can you describe Bühler's purpose in one word?
And what were the results?
And then I had Stefan react to it. And he felt that they had really done a good job in capturing the essence of Bühler, which means whatever you're doing, without even communicating your, you're not blasting them with your one-line statement, they have captured the, they've understood what you stand for. Now, back to, Stefan made a very important point about long-term, short-term. Now, if these, and these were all positive statements, by the way, it was about sustainability, it was about collaboration, it was about partnership, it was about innovation, right? It was about relationship, right? All these things creates customer loyalty, right? What is, now, the payoff can be short-term, but it's definitely long-term, right? So how, this is the, I think the part that people get, another point of confusion is, purpose is a tax on business. Purpose is, how much are you going to give away to charity and sustainability? So now, Stefan, you're going to have carbon offsets and you're going to pay for this and you're going to send employee for training, you're going to give them good benefits. You know, all this is costing the shareholders money. And, you know, come on, you know, juice up the profits. But if Stefan says, no, if I have really productive, talented employees who are upskilled and are going to stay with us because they want to be here, it may have not have give us results this quarter, but, you know, give it three, four, five quarters, what are you going to get in the future? So the question is this optimization problem in what time horizon? And I think if you look at all the investors like Larry Fink and others who are talking about purpose, what are they saying to leaders of public companies? Please think like leaders in some of these companies, private companies. Mm. Have an eye on the prize in the long term, but deliver results in the short term, which are markers towards long term. It's not saying ignore short term, only give me long term. Mm. So that's also very important. And I think this is the part that employees need to understand, that purpose doesn't mean relax, we're a cool company. Purpose means you should be energized to win.
Can I wind things up by asking each of you the same question, but get your different take? Stefan, I'll come to you first of all. How optimistic are you now, looking to the future, that what you're doing is right and the business can make a difference?
Well, Paul, I'm, after these 2 days of the networking days, engaging with 1,000 international guests and partners, and then also before building up to it with 2,000 people from Switzerland and 600 people from all over the world of Bühler who joined us here, I'm more convinced than ever. It gave us so much positive energy. It gave us alignment. It gave us a feeling of, you know, passion and also optimism. Yeah, optimism is perhaps the right word as well, that we rally behind the cause and we are not alone in it. I mean, the confirmation that you have from 1,000 global leaders of the industries, right? Feeding about 4 billion people through the products of their companies. I think there cannot be any better testimony. And if this is not enough, I don't know how much you want to have as far as this is concerned. So I must say I'm very optimistic.
And Ranjay, would you share that optimism?
You know, I think I never fully understood how profound the food industry is in shaping our, you know, you take food for granted. You know, honestly, I never thought about, you know, it's a, you assume, I mean, I was fortunate that growing up as a kid, there was always food on the table, right? Now, growing up in India, you knew others did not have food. But I never thought about the complexity behind the production of food. When I ate that piece of Indian roti, chapati, I did not think about the wheat milling that happened behind it and the growing and the value chain of food, and how that has consequences for the environment, and how global it touches everybody, every human being. And to me, it was just stunning to see the people I talked to who were saying that, you know, I think people have were talking about how they realize more and more so the consequences of their business, not only for the consumer, end consumer and the customer and the value chain in between, but also for the planet. I think that raising awareness was very inspiring to me. That I think people are, coming to terms and looking for, I think people have understood this is an issue. I think people are looking for a way forward. And that's why the purpose conversation, I think, was a great conversation to have, because it gives you one starting point into this journey. That if you're going to embrace sustainability and you want to think about purpose and performance, maybe there's a way to get into this, into this space. And I think, so it's very energizing and inspiring to me to hear the stories I got to hear.
Well, that's good to hear. Ranjay, it's been a pleasure. Thanks for joining us. Thank you, Stefan, too. And thank you for watching. So the message is, don't just have a purpose, have a deep purpose. Make a difference.